Good morning to all of you. Namaste. I'm Dr. Shruti Mishra. I'm Assistant Professor and the Coordinator in the Department of Management and Commerce, Faculty of Law and Governance. Today we will going to discuss about the store layout. Now this is the first session of the store layout. In the another session we will discuss about the types. In this session we will discuss about the what exactly store layout means, what are the objectives and what are the factors affecting the store layout. So we'll start with the store layout meaning. The store layout needs to guide the customer silently and about where he or she wants to go for expose him and for exposing him or her to the entire store offerings. So basically the store layout should be maintained in such a manner that the when the customer steps in into the retail store, they should get the holistic idea about the retail store things. What are the what this is a retail store meant for? How many things they are selling? What types of products they are having? What type of offers they are displaying? So this all need to be very silently focused to all the customers. Now the store layout is to develop the good store layout. Stores designers must balance the objectives that often conflict. For example, the store layout should entice the customers to move around the store to purchase more merchandise than they may have originally planned. So sometimes what happens when you go out, when you have planned that you need to buy these three things, but you go into the retail store and you are seeing so many of the things and you are watching out so many of the things, then what do you feel? Then I should buy this and this and that. Then you maintain a list of 10 items, but you are going to buy just three items and now you are buying 10 items. So that's how the retail store should be maintained. Now, however, the retail the layout is too complex. Customers may find it difficult to locate the merchandise and they are looking for they decide not to patronize the store. Sometimes what happens if the retail store is not properly up to the mark, they have not made the layout in the proper manner, the customer got confused and that's why the customer cannot able to buy anything and they just came out. Similarly, they walk into the store and they came out from the store. Now, what are the objectives of the retail stores? Store design. The first is to guide the customers around the store and the intense increase of the purchase. Second is to create the balance between the sales and the shopping space. The third one is to create the effective merchandising presentation. The fourth one is to use multi-level to provide the sense of variety. Now, what Big Bazaar does? Big Bazaar have the retail stores at the three levels. The first one is about the grocery products. Second one is about the you can say about the clothing area, and the third one is about the dining and you know the home decor. So that's how they have prioritized their things. The person step into the market, they'll buy the grocery products, that is the, on the priority basis. Second, they are going to purchase the clothes, and third, then they will go to the decor. So that's how they have maintained such a way that it should provide the sense of variety. Now next, the factors affecting the store layout. The total space available to the these types of products and the merchandise offered by the store. Number of the departments in the store, volume and the variety in the store, and the ratio and the product line carried, mode of the operation, movement required to store, locating, picking, the storing the product, target customers and the average number of the customers visiting these stores, degree of the changes in the operation, stock inventory level. So these are the basically factors affecting the store layout. So as students, I hope this is all for the day and you like this video. If you are having any kind of query, please do let me know. I'll definitely problems. Thank you so much, students. Have a great day.